Welcome to day 5 of Launch Week, where we have an org switcher and a user profile component, and we have two demos that we'd like to show you. So first up, we have Sherry. Sherry, welcome, and thank you for taking some time to show us this this new org switcher component.
Yeah, thank you. So I'm just going to do a demo of the org switcher real quick. So we have a demo app here that we're just going to sign into. So this particular user has multiple organizations that they're a member of. So let's just select Work OS. So now with this new org switcher widget, you can now switch between your organizations pretty seamlessly. So let's say we wanted to switch to that other organization. So this current one, we have two users. If I were to switch into this other one, we see that only I'm a member of this particular one. You can kind of throw this org switcher into whatever different application you have with your specific theme that you can customize. It's pretty trivial to modify the overall layout of it.
Awesome. So what does this look like to implement on the code side of things?
Yeah, so this is pretty trivial to implement. If you're using one of our front-end SDKs, so for example, the AuthKit React SDK, we have a hook called useAuth, and within it, we provide the functionality to switch to organizations. So if you're using this organization switcher widget, you essentially pop that action into the switch to organization parameter, and it should just work.
That's awesome. And awesome also that you're just flexing with the Tmux and Neo, by the way. Awesome. Well, this is a great demo. Thank you so much, Sherry. We're also going to check out the user profile component by Lucas. Lucas, show us what you got.
Of course. Let's take a look at the user profile. So the user profile here, you can see that you get the ability to see your avatar, personal details, like your name, email address, and all the connected accounts that you have in. So you can also change your name. Let's say I am called just Lucas Mota, getting rid of my other surname. So yeah, this is user profile. And next we also have user sessions. And user sessions is basically, you can see the active sessions you have, which is in this case here, shows my current device. Yes, I'm on Safari, but I also have other devices, which is Google Chrome, which I can sign out from. I can also sign out from all the other devices, which is not this one. So let's give that a go, right? So sign out from all other devices. Boom, done. And now the list updates, so I only have Safari now, which is my current device. And lastly, we have user security, right? Which shows all the details about your security that you have enabled in the dashboard. In this case, I have password, two-factor authentication, and passkeys enabled. So now let's set up the two-factor authentication. So let's bring this modal here. And you will see that we have this extra step of validation. So let's verify this code. You're going to get an email. Here we are. We enter the code. Okay, so now we're in. Now you can get the authenticator app and configure that. So in order, you can either scan the QR code, right? Or you can copy and paste this key, go to my authenticator app, and I'm gonna enter now 6 digit from the authenticator app, and this is it. And we also have passkeys that you can add passkeys, delete the passkey, and this is about it for user security.
I love this. So now this is actually implemented into your app. So could we see the application code, like how complex is it to actually get all this inside of your application?
Absolutely. Yeah, let's have a look. So let's go to the editor here. Let's start with the Work OS widgets. This is where you configure the main kind of like provider for those widgets. That's where you customize the main appearance of your widget too. And then we have each component, which is only receives an auth token, which you get from the Work OS SDK. And you pass it down to each component. So you have user profile, user sessions, which you can also pass the current session ID, and also user security. So again, there is not much else you have to do. It's super easy for you to just drop in the component and get these entire features like working for you.
If we wanted to change some just like broad styling with Radix themes, what does that look like?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have full access to the same props that we allow in Radix themes. So if you want to change the appearance, let's say you have this white, like a bit slightly rounded, and I want to change a little bit. I want to change the main accent color to something like jade, for example. And I'm going to change the appearance as well to be dark. And I don't want border radius. I just want normal, right? And if we refresh, come back here, you see here that now everything is kind of like squared. It's a dark UI profile picture here. If you see square two, everything follows along. There is much more customization that you can check the docs, but you can customize individual elements as well. As you can see here, the badge elements, you can customize its color too. So you can change these too. And then you see here that affects the badge itself, right? The rest still follows the same kind of like jade color, but the badge follows a different one.
Yeah, it's so simple, but so nice too. And it looks like, given the fact that these are different components, you can kind of create a layout however you want around these widgets.
Yeah. It's, again, you have full control over the rest. You can have any layouts. You can also have, let's say, a dialogue that has the same widgets. So this is an example showing how would those components behave on like a tab, for example. You control the tab, you control the dialogue, and you just place the component where you want. And again, you get this super easily.
That's awesome. Well, Lucas, thank you so much for showing us the new WorkOS widgets for user profile. That's it for day 5, which wraps up launch week for us. So if you want to learn more about any of the things that we released this week, check out workos.com/launch-week and see everything new to WorkOS. Thanks again for tuning into Launch Week. We can't wait to see what you build. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.